The next thing to do is to actually introduce a screen where a user can, let's say, have a home view and access their profile. So in the layout now, we're going to do is we're going to add a new screen, and it's going to be a custom screen, and it's going to be called, let's call it home.
Fonty.
Home icon. Perfect. Now, before I go any further, what I'm going to do is introduce another table. And this is going to be a new table called configuration. And what this table is for now, you can simply populate a single column of name with, let's say, the name of your app. Now, the reason for this is because when you create a new screen in Glide, any screen has a data source. And I think a common mistake is to include different data sources for different screens within the app. And sometimes that can get confusing. And there's a number of reasons why I would advise against it. And a best practice that I've picked up over the years is to create an empty table called configuration, or globals, or whatever you want to call it. And you might want to include some imagery and the logo of your app and things like that. And what we're going to do is have that as the data source for every single new screen that you add to the app. In pretty much any case, you can do this. Firstly, what that will allow you to do is to pull any imagery and colors and visuals that you have in this configuration table onto any screen without needing to sort of find them from other tables. But also it keeps the whole app super clean. So we've introduced our home screen, and we've called it home. The source for this screen is going to be configuration, and we're going to delete everything. So I always recommend a custom styling on a Glide app screen. The reason for this is because if I choose, for example, card or grid or list or any of these other ones, what it means is it's much harder to add other components and to customize your screen, because things like cards and grids and checklists and all of these, they can be added to a custom screen. So what we're going to do is start off with a custom screen. Again, I recommend this as a rule of thumb on any view. Introduce custom as the style on a screen. So we have our home screen. So let's display a little header with the profile information of the given user, right? So the first thing we're going to do is over in the components view, we're going to add in a container. Containers are great in Glide because they allow you to compartmentalize all of the information that you're displaying. And also you can give them background colors and things like that. So we'll introduce a container, and within that container, we're going to have a title component. I like the profile one, but it's personal preference. They tend to function in the same way. They just look slightly different. So we're going to go for a profile, a title component, and the name is going to be the name of the app. So family to-dos, it's pulling it straight from configuration, because that's the tab that this data source is providing. So we're going to go with the name of the app, and the subtitle, let's say, is the user profile nickname. Great. The next thing we're going to do is select an image. So that is going to be the user profile's photo to display. So that if we're viewing as myself, as dad, we can pull through my photo, and that's where this if-then-else column comes into play. So if we go and view as Emily, she's going to see her icon like that. And finally, what we're going to do is on this container, we're going to give it a background of, let's say, the app accent color. So that suddenly starts to pop a little bit. I think that looks really nice. Great. So once we've done this, it would be good for the user to be able to, let's say, access their profile and be able to perhaps edit their photo and their nickname. So what we can do, and I'm going to make this compact, so it's slightly smaller. what we're going to do is we're going to have an action on this title, and this is going to be called my profile. Oops. Great. And the icon for this, let's say, is this one. That makes sense. Now, the action on here is going to be navigation, show user profile screen. So Glide have provided you with the functionality to go straight to the user's profile view. And we're going to copy this container. Another thing that's great about putting information into a container is that you can copy the whole container with all of your different components in it and paste it somewhere else in the app. So now that we've set the action up on this title component, we're going to click on it, and that will show Glide's default user profile view. So from here, we can remove what we had. We can paste in R1. And this is going to be showing, the title is going to be the user profile's name. Let's say the subtitle is the user profile's nickname, which we already have from the previous view. And the image is going to be the photo that we're looking to display there. So on this view, let's make it look slightly different so that we can see a distinction when we move between the two views. So let's perhaps go for a simple view here. And let's set this button, the action on the title, to actually be edit. And we'll choose our pencil. And this is going to, we're going to choose navigation, show edit screen. This item as, let's say, an overlay. So what we're now going to be able to do within our profile is tap edit, where we can actually in real time edit some of this information. So we've got our name and photo, which Glide has pulled through for us. We're also going to want the nickname, and let's make sure these are required fields so that nobody can leave them empty. The photo, of course, is going to be optional. Great. So now a user can go and edit their profile. So I might actually just want it to be called Oscar, let's say. Great. And then we can have another button. So you can add multiple actions off of a title component, which is really cool as well. So let's say this is actually going to take us home. And this is going to be navigation, go to tab, home. So just like that, we've now got a basic app that somebody can sign into. If they're in the users table, they can access their profile, which they can edit. So that's really cool.
If you found this video useful and want to learn more, be sure to check out our full course, where we dive deep into building and customizing apps with Glide and other no-code tools. It provides comprehensive tutorials and expert guidance to help you build professional-grade applications. If you're new here, or if you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, share it with your friends, leave any questions that you have below, and we'll see you in the next video.